In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a particle logo animation just like this in After Effects using the Trapcode Particular plugin, which you can download via the link in the description, so let's get to it. So here we are in After Effects. I'm going to create a new composition. It will be in 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, 10 seconds for the duration, click OK. Then drag the logo PNG to the timeline. Press S on the keyboard to reduce its scale if needed, I'll decrease mine, and reposition the logo into the center of the composition. And after you do that, let's pre-compose the logo by a right-click, pre-compose, I'm going to name it logo, and make sure move all attributes is selected, then click OK. Now we want to create the mask. For that, we want to make sure that the layer is highlighted, then select the rectangle tool, and create a simple mask like this. Then press M on the keyboard to see the mask path property. Make sure you are at the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for mask path. I'm going to switch to the selection tool, and I'm going to drag on any of the corner points and move the mask to the left out of the frame like this. And that will be at the start. Let's move 5 seconds forward or 6 seconds forward and drag the mask across to the other side and make sure that you move it out of the frame as well. Then press F on a keyboard and increase the mask feather to something like 70. That'll soften the edges of the mask. At this point, we can pre-compose the composition by right-click pre-compose and call it emitter. Click OK. And now we want to make the emitter layer 3D, and if you don't see this column, click toggle switches on mode until you do and make it 3D by checking this icon, and hide its visibility by toggling the eye icon. Now we need to create a solid layer. For that, we go up to layer, new, solid. You can call it particles or particular. The color doesn't matter, click OK. Then open effects and presets window, search for particular, and add particular to the solid. Then head over to the effect controls panel, and here we're going to adjust the look of the particles. So if you move a bit forward on the timeline, you will see the particles. So here, first we want the emitter, so open the settings. In the emitter type, we're going to select a layer. Then here you will see the layer emitter settings, expand that. In the layer, we want to select the emitter. Now go up to the particles per second settings and set it really high, so like 500,000. And then you should see the particles with the same colors as your logo. Then I'm going to set emitter size to 50. I'll leave velocity at 100. Let's scroll down and open the particle settings. I'm going to set life to 2 seconds. Life random 100%. Then size, I'll set it to 6. Size random 100. Then expand size over life. Presets, and I'm going to choose the second preset. Scroll down to the opacity over life. Expand it. Presets, and here select the last preset. Scroll down to the environment settings, and here for the gravity, I'm going to set it to negative 50, wind x 100, and wind y to negative 50. Then I'm going to expand air turbulence, and set effect position to 100, that'll randomly displace the particles throughout the scene. Then I'm going to scroll further to the lighting, and to shadowlets, enable shadowlets, and I'm going to keep the default settings so they are very, very subtle. And here, if we do the preview, here are the particles. So now let's enhance the look of the particles by adding a few effects. So search for curves in effects and presets. Add the curve to the particular or the particle solid layer. I'm going to create 2 points like this. I'm going to drag this one up and this one slightly up. So something like that. So that'll make the particles brighter and more vivid. Now let's search for another effect, glow. Of course, we want to add glow, the stylized glow added to the particles. And here I'm going to increase the glow threshold to something like 70, and then increase the glow radius to something like 200. And if we have a look at the particles, they should be a lot better looking now. Yep, I like that. So after we've done with the particles, we want to add the actual logo reveal. So for that, let's go back to the project panel, drag and drop the logo composition below other layers. Then in effect controls, search for linear wipe effect and add the linear wipe to the logo composition. Then in effect controls, set the wipe angle to be negative 90, as feather set it to 70. Then let's move to the start of the timeline. Let's increase the transition completion all the way to 100 and create a keyframe. Then let's go to 5 seconds, so that's the end for the particles for us, and set it to 0. And now if we do the preview, we should have the particles animating first and then the logo underneath them. And in case if you find the timing to be off, meaning that the logo appears first before the particles, You can simply move the logo layer forward in time by a few frames and adjust the timing, but don't go too much, but like 10 frames will be fine. And here, if we do the preview, we should have a very nice particle logo animation. And after we've done that, let's add the solid as the background. So layer, new solid, call it BG, put it below other layers. I'm going to search for fill, add it to the solid layer, and choose the color that somewhat matches the logo's color. So in this case, we have a lot of colors, so I'll do something like blue and make it very, very dark, like that. Now let's also add a zoom animation throughout the scene. So for that, we need to unlock the layer emitter first, then drag and select all the layers, right click any of them, pre-compose, and let's call this one final, is the final comp, click OK, and then press S on the keyboard to see the scale. Let's move to the start. Or actually, if you look here, in the first second, we don't even see the logo. It only started like 1 second, 10 frames or so. So let me come to one second, then press B to bring the start of the work area to 1 second. And here I'm going to create a keyframe for scale at 100, then move to the end of the animation, and that would be 6 seconds, maybe even 7 seconds. So yeah, at the point that we don't see the particle, so 7 seconds. I'm going to press N to bring the work area end to 7 seconds. So this is the work area and the preview area. And I'm going to increase the scale to say something like 125. And now the scene will be zooming toward us throughout the animation. And here is our complete particle logo reveal animation done in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.